I wasn't going to say anything, but I have breaking news for you, Mr. President. You may not have heard this. Just moments ago, Joe Biden stated that our supporters are garbage.
The only garbage I see floating out there is his supporters.
So you have, remember Hillary? She said deplorable. And then she said irredeemable, right? But she said deplorable. That didn't work out. Garbage, I think, is worse. Thank you very much. So this outfit, you know, is when he called us all garbage. How stupid. What a stupid word. That blows deplorable away, don't you think? Of course, I thought irredeemable when she said deplorable or irredeemable. I thought irredeemable was actually worse, but deplorable seemed to catch up. But this garbage stuff blows it away. So I'm in this beautiful plane. I'm enjoying myself. Have a wonderful suit on. And one of my people came in and said, sir, you know, the word garbage is the hottest thing right now out there. The hottest thing out there. Sir, would you like to drive a garbage truck? Now, we're about, you know, 30 minutes from landing. We had to do this pretty quick. I said, it's sort of cool, though, isn't it? Because, you know. And I said, you know, I think that's okay. But, you know, I don't feel comfortable wearing a suit. And they pulled up this garbage truck. I don't know how the hell they did it so fast. I have very capable people. They put a big sign on the truck. Did you see it? I think they showed it to me. And then they said, sir, we have a vest. I said, well, should I leave my suit on and put it over the vest? But that doesn't look very good, right? That doesn't look good. So I said, all right, look, let me take it off. And then I actually said, I climbed into the truck, but here's the, so I said, how the hell do you get into this truck? It's way up high. It's a big one. This was a beauty. I said, you didn't have to buy it that big, right? You have to get it that big. They brought this brand new, gorgeous truck, wonderful driver. He looked like Cary Grant in his prime. You know who that is? This beautiful driver. And he drove that big thing up. And I said, man, this is bad, because now I have all the cameras are all watching. Look at all the fake news. They were most of them. Now, most of them. Many of them were there, and I'm saying, oh, boy. You know, one little mistake with these guys, and your political career is over. You can't even. So I said, man, if I don't get up there, this is going to be very embarrassing. These stupid people, they'll say, he's cognitively and physically impaired. And I can't do that when I'm alongside of this great athlete. I got to get up to that. So the first stair is like up here. I'm saying, shit. So I had the adrenaline going and I made it. I made it. And then I gave a little news conference from the front of the, you know, they asked their wise guy questions and everything. And then we drove about 2 feet. I got out, got into the plane. And then I got in the car, and I'm driving over here, and I have this still on. And I come into the arena, and I say, where's my jacket? I want to get out of this thing. And they said, it would be unbelievable if you could wear it on stage. I said, no way. I got 25,000 people standing outside. I got all these people here. There's no way I'm wearing it on stage. They said, oh, okay, sir. I said, get me my jacket. But if you did, you know, it actually makes you look thinner. I said, ooh. And they got me. I said, I want to wear it on stage. When they said I look thinner, I said, in that case, I'll wear it on stage. I may never wear a blue jacket again. I may go in this. I said that. That was my, that was the word. That was the key. Sir, you look thinner. So anyway, so we had a little fun about a very serious subject. We had a little fun about a time where our country is not having a lot of fun because we're not doing well as a country, but we're going to be doing well very shortly. I promise you that. And then I got in the car and I'm driving over here and I have this still on. And I come into the arena and I say, where's my jacket? I want to get out of this thing. And they said, it would be unbelievable if you could wear it on stage. I said, and I said, no way. I got 25,000 people standing outside. I got all these people here. There's no way I'm wearing it on stage. They said, oh, okay, sir. I said, get me my jacket. But if you did, you know, it actually makes you look thinner. I said, oh. And they got me. I said, I want to wear it on stage. When they said I look thinner, I said, in that case, I'll wear it on stage. I may never wear a blue jacket again. I may go in this. I said that. That was the word. That was the key. Sir, you look thinner. So anyways. I have to begin by saying 250 million Americans are not garbage. This week, Kamala has been comparing her political opponents to the most evil mass murderers in history. And now, speaking on a call for her campaign last night, Crooked Joe Biden finally said what he and Kamala really think of our supporters. He called them garbage. No way. No way! And they actually mean it, even though without question, my supporters are far higher quality than Crooked Joe or Lion Kamala. Higher quality. Higher quality. My response to Joe and Kamala is very simple. You can't lead America if you don't love Americans. That's true. You can't be president if you hate the American people, which I believe. Kamala and Joe call all of us, and them, even them, garbage. I call you the heart and soul of America. You are the heart and soul. You built our country. You know? You built our country. You built it. Far more than they built it, I can tell you that. How do you like my garbage truck? This truck is in honor of Kamala and Joe Biden.
Is the greatest troll in political history. This is Donald Trump driving the garbage truck literally 12 hours after Joe Biden called Donald Trump and all of his supporters garbage. This is absolutely amazing. If you have any doubt to where this person knows the culture, this person knows how to create a moment. As a matter of fact, Donald Trump is the moment, because this is amazing. It's iconic. It's incredible. It is so many of the things. I got to tell you, whoever is behind Trump's social media team, whoever is doing the comms, whoever is on the social team is really, like, they really did their big one right here, because this is something else. This is iconic. This is amazing. And what I love about this is that it's a purely cultural moment, but it also is a visual that reminds everybody that Joe Biden, less than 12 hours ago, called Trump supporters garbage. And basically what he's saying is that, yeah, Joe Biden may have called you all garbage, but you all and we all, as in the people that are supporting Donald Trump, are about to take out the trash on Tuesday.
Joe Biden called half of the country garbage. In response, Donald Trump is driving around in a garbage truck. But the disdain for half of the country is not a new thing. We haven't just been called garbage, we've been called deplorables, Nazis, domestic terrorists, we've been called all kinds of nasty fascist and racist and every possible insult that they could come up with for half of the country. Kamala Harris and Joe Biden continue to sling mud at innocent, hardworking Americans. She wants to talk about unifying the country. Yeah, well, maybe a start would be to not call us all fascist in the last week of the election, and maybe not have your boss call us garbage.
The ultimate troll move just happened. Let's have a discussy-scush. So I'm sure we've all heard by now that on a live stream, Joe Biden was heard calling all of Trump's supporters garbage. And in good fashion, we all know that Donald Trump is a little trollster, apparently. We saw the stunt that he pulled when it came to McDonald's and serving people through a drive-thru. Well, he's at it again. This man went out and purchased a garbage truck. He purchased a garbage truck. He made sure to make it to the nines. He put his logo on there, his campaign slogan. You know, it looks nice. It's a nice garbage truck, honestly. He then drives by the media and says that he's dedicating the truck to Kamala and Joe Biden. Now, I don't care what side of the fence you are on. And we all know petty when we see it. And let me tell you, I am here for this. Is it sad that two presidential candidates are at each other's throats? Yeah. Is it sad that I feel like we're just in this gigantic high school lunchroom and people are arguing and yelling at each other? Yeah. But at the end of the day, if you can laugh about something and genuinely find humor and joy in it, why not? My dude bought a garbage truck. So in a world where there's so much chaos, it is actually refreshing to see these kinds of things happening. Again, petty, yes, but I'm here for it. The ultimate gotcha moment. Have a great night.
Racist, sexist, homophobic, xenophobic, Islamophobic, you name it.
Or Puerto Rico, where I'm in my home state of Delaware, they're good, decent, honorable people. The only garbage I see floating out there is his supporters.
You said over the weekend, referring to it, there's a direct parallel to a big rally that happened in the mid-1930s at Madison Square Garden.
Well, look,
you were comparing that rally to a Nazi rally?
Look, I'm comparing it to the hate that came out of this, and I think they confirmed that.
You stand by that comparison, though, to a Nazi rally?
Look, the rally, you saw it for yourself. I'll let the American public make the decision of what they saw.
What about you, though?
So I know what I saw, and I'll just leave it at that.
Do you think Donald Trump is a fascist?
Yes, I do.